फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ स्ट्रेंथनिंग बॉन्ड्स। आई हिमाली गडा गोइंग टू ब्रिंग आउट अ डिफरेंट टॉपिक टुडे, एंड दैट टॉपिक इज लर्निंग। लर्निंग नॉट फॉर आवर चिल्ड्रन, बट लर्निंग फॉर अस, फॉर यू एंड मी, पेरेंट्स एंड फॉर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स। यस, यू हर्ड इट करेक्टली। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन लर्निंग, व्हाई लर्निंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर नॉट फॉर चिल्ड्रन बट फॉर वी एडल्ट्स। Now, what is learning? Learning is acquiring a new skill, something that we didn't knew and now we know it. Why is it important for us to learn? Two things. One, it is important for us to learn for our brain development. But that's not the entire focus here in this session. The entire focus is to learn because you can understand what the child goes through. Now, learning could be as simple thing as you can. But just learning, if you don't know how to operate a computer, learn to operate a computer. Learn to go on a different app. Learn how to download an app. Learn maybe just a new game. Maybe Antakshari or Atlas, which you would have, Atlas something you wouldn't have played. Or maybe Stone Paper Scissor, something which is very common among the young children. Learn something to, like a cube, to solve a cube. Now, why do I insist on learning? Is, suppose when you're going to solve a cube or anything, I'm just taking this cube as an example, there are many things that you need to take care of. One, you have to understand your finger movements. You have to turn this way, then you will use this finger or this hand or what way it could be. Second, the steps. So, if I want to have this layer, then I need to follow some rules. If I want to have the second layer done, I have to follow some rules. And I have to start thinking with this set of rules. Now, it's just not this cube. It could be anything that you learn. But what happens is, when you are actually understanding the rules and starting to think in between of those rules or with the boundaries of those rules, you will actually see that this some kind of alertness that you're putting in. There's some kind of efforts that are coming from your end. Now, these efforts that are coming from your end will come as some barriers, some problems. Oh, it's so tough, I can't do it. This solving, I just go to fix one side and the other side gets a problem. It is very difficult for me to solve it. I will never be able to do that. Possible for you to come with that communication. But the moment you get a hold on, maybe you just did a bit, there's something different that you will go through. Something different to achieve even one layer. Now, when you go through this process of learning, understanding, forgetting, getting some problems, again learning, again getting present to what you missed out, and so on, will make you actually able to understand your child well. It is very easy for us to tell the children, learn this, do this, ye kaise aata nahi malum, ye sikho. It's very simple. And it's very simple for them to learn as compared to us. I don't deny that. That's the real fact. But it does not mean that when learning is simple for them, that they do not get any problems or concerns or questions. They do have barriers. They do fail sometimes. They do get frustrated. Like just solving this cube again and again and again, and you forget the formulas. You have the formulas written on the paper and then do you forget it? You may forget how to go to that app. You would have written it. You've gone through it 10 times. Again, you would fail it. It would happen many times. That's exactly what we need to understand. What we experience when we are not able to do something. Now, that experience is exactly what children face. Now, their severity is much more. Why? Because they are very agile. The age that they are not sound and settled in life like you and I are. For us, even big challenges and big problems will not make that difference. But for them, just a friend not picking up the call or not talking to them properly will disturb their sleep. For us, it won't. So what I want to say is, even small things will matter to our children. In this scenario, we hardly have an opening to understand what they are going through. We hardly have an opening where we can actually put our foot into their shoes. And learning is one of the best things where you actually experience what they experience. So it could be still something that you can do alone. You can take some jigsaw puzzle, start solving it. Even that's a kind of learning. You think differently. You would have any games in the lockdown period to play with your children. Take those games which you've never ever played. Okay? The ground rule. You've never ever played. It's something new that you are learning. It would be Uno or something or the other. Given you a lot of examples, friends. The only reason I insist is, till you do not understand what they are going through, you do not understand what they experience. Until you do not understand what the other person experiences, whatever you say will not have a ground. The moment you understand that yes, learning is difficult, this is all not difficult. I don't mean that learning is difficult, okay? The point that I want to put down is, there are some barriers, there are some challenges that the child faces. The moment you get that, you actually get present to the experience that they are going. When you get that experience, okay, it's not that smooth to learn something. If it's maybe a chapter of English, there will be certain questions, certain things that the child will not understand. There will be certain, just not education, certain things in your home that you teach to your child. Maybe in this lockdown period, there will be certain things in our household course that we want our children to do, and they would have never done it and they have to learn it. It's just not with children, it would be even with the adults. But here, what comes in between is something which is unknown. And there's where lot of friction generates. The reason to generate the friction is, we get present to the fact that we have learned a lot in our life and learning is simple. Because we do not remember the process of learning or what all we went through the learning. We remember the outcomes. Like, I know cycling, I know how simple it is. I know to solve this cube, I know how simple it is. But for me to learn something which I don't know is something a challenge. But that's not in our memory now. So friends, you would be a father, you would be a grandfather, you would be an uncle, you would be an aunt to the child, or you are an individual independent person, no children around you. Whosoever you are, I recommend you to learn. Learn for your development and learn to understand what these teenagers and children would be going through. And after understanding that, the way you communicate, after knowing what the other person goes through, your communication will land at a very different level. There will no more be frictions, there will be support. Okay, you're stuck here. Now, what's a simple way to do that? You will now come with options. What all can be possible? Friends, it's not important that you know things or you don't know things. Okay? It's important that if you don't know, what are you doing about it? When you want your children to learn all those things, what kind of role model are you being? If you put as a parent or as a caretaker, as learning bachcho ka kaam hai, we are not there to learn, what you do is, you do not have learning as an enjoyment. The association with learning, like, wow, I want it every time. Why don't you want to learn? Is missing. What's coming in life is, hey, learning is a pressure burden. I've gone through that life. You have to face it. Come on, face it. There's a naked language that I'm saying. You and I don't speak that, but that's what children understand. The unsaid words. When we say, meri sikhne ki umar gayi, ab main nahi sikh sakta. Now I can't learn, now I can't change. Friends, when do we stop learning? In real life, in actual life, we never stop learning. We will not stop learning also the day when our legs would be weak, will not stop learning to use that lakdi, a stick for us to walk. We will not stop learning how to walk smoothly with that walker. We will not. If that's a requirement, we will do all those learnings in our life. Maybe we are at the age of 70, 80, 85, 90. No matter. Our teeth would have gone. We would start learning to eat without the teeth. Our eyes, our vision would be weak. We would start learning to see and understand the world with this vision, weak vision. Friends, in our life, we never actually stop learning. But the point is, we learn when there is extreme necessity. I invite you to learn without that extreme necessity, but just because you can learn and you are still young to learn. Friends, with this I complete today's session. Stay home, stay safe, go on learning. And for those who have not watched the earlier videos, go to our website, hungrybrain.in. In videos, see strengthening homes. Enjoy strengthening bonds. I'm sorry. Enjoy learning, enjoy playing.